Hello friends, welcome to Quick Chess Videos. Today we are going to see a beautiful game of Vasily Ivanchuk played against Peter Lako in the tournament Legends of Chess 2020. In this tournament, the youngsters and the legends compete against each other for the prize fund of $1 million. The game started with e4, e5, and the very infamous King's Gambit f4. The idea of f4 is if black captures on f4, white can occupy the center. E into f4, knight f3. Okay, if white plays d4 trying to capture the center, it is possible, but there is queen h4 check and there can be some issues with the king. So white first played knight f3, now preparing d4, h6. Okay, the idea of h6 is to play g5 and hold on to this extra pawn. There's another line, which is d5, e captures d5, knight f6, which turns out to be fine for black. Okay, after knight f3, h6, black wants to play g5, d4 to control the center, g5, and white played here g3. Black can here continue as g4, knight h4, and f3 as well, but in this game black captured the pawn on g3. Pawn captures g3, bishop g7, trying to develop the pieces, knight c3, d6, bishop e3, knight f6, queen d2, trying to castle on the long side, knight g4, attacking the bishop, so white protects the bishop, bishop g1. Knight to c6, long castles, short castles. Okay, up till now we can assume that as the kings are on the opposite side of the board, the side which will attack first is eventually be better. So Ivanchuk starts first with the move to dislocate this knight, as this knight is very powerful defender of the king. So he starts with the move knight h2. Black captures on h2, rook captures on h2, bishop g4 attacking the rook. Ivanchuk just moves it. It would be a mistake to play bishop e2, as after exchanging many pieces are getting exchanged, so the attacking chances will become difficult. Instead, white just went on for rook e1, knight e7, trying to bring the knight here for the defense. We can see here that white king is comparatively safe than black's king, because white's king's pawn have not moved yet, while black's pawn have expanded, so there are some weaknesses in the camp. White just still continued developing the pieces, bishop g2, queen d7, bishop e3. We can already see that some kind of sacrifice may come over here just to open up the king. Knight g6, and white brought his last piece into the attack with rook h1. Now both the rooks are lined up against the king. We can see bishop and queen are also working towards the king, and there will be some kind of sacrifice trying to open up the position of the black's king and to create an attack. Black played c6 and white played a brilliant move. You can pause the video and guess it out. Rook captures pawn. A brilliant sacrifice just to open up opponent's king. Now this pawn will also be lost as you cannot protect it by f6 because rook can capture the knight. Instead, black played king g7, trying to bring the rook to h8 to exchange the rook. If the rooks will be exchanged, the attacking potential is gonna reduce. Bishop captures pawn. Okay, so in this position, if we try to analyze this position, white has 6 pawns for black's 5 pawns and white is exchanged down. But against that, the main factor in this position is that black's king is very weak, which gives him very good compensation for the exchange. The black's king is going to be permanent weakness, hence white is a very good compensation. Okay, black played f6, attacking the bishop. Okay, Ivanchuk just protected it with bishop e3. Rook h8, b3, just safeguarding the king. Maybe he can bring the king to b2 in the future to protect it more. Black took on h6, bishop into h6, king h7, bishop f1. The idea of bishop f1 is to bring the bishop to d3 to again create an attack on the black's king by pushing the pawn sometimes in the future. Bishop h3, bishop e2, rook e8, safeguarding his own king. That is a good principle. Before you attack opponent's king, you should make your king safe. b5, bishop d3. Earlier also bishop d3 could have been good. Now his idea is to play e5 sometimes, trying to open up the bishop. Queen g4, attacking this pawn. But Ivanchuk decides to sacrifice it, as taking this pawn will open more lines towards the black's king. Black pushed pawn, attacking the knight. Knight d1. The idea is to play knight f2. Queen captures g3. Queen captures b4. Bishop g4. And this is one of the most critical moments of the game. If white's knight is attacked, and if the knight moves somewhere, then probably the bishop will be taken. And if you take the bishop, the queen will come to g5, and we can see that white's attacking pieces have reduced a lot. So this is the most critical moment of the game. Try to think here for yourself, how did white continue his attack? He played e5, brilliant move. Okay, let's see some variations. First of all, what happens if bishop captures the knight? If bishop could have taken the knight, white would have prepared giving a check. And the point is, you cannot block it with the rook because queen will capture the rook and the knight is pinned. And in the next move, white just takes the pawn, threatening not taking the pawn, but just he can simply play many moves. Queen e6 check and take this pawn or take this pawn, and white is in a completely winning position. And instead of blocking it with the rook, if he goes back, then we can capture the pawn on f6, threatening queen g7 mate. If black tries to defend it with rook g8, we can see the knight cannot move, because if the knight moves, then there will be queen h7 checkmate. So if black tries to protect it with rook g8, white just plays bishop h6, trying to again threaten some very nasty checks, and white would be again having a very winning attack. So capturing the knight is very risky. If you capture the pawn, then also it's losing because of queen b7 check, king h8. Again, same point, you cannot bring in the rook because queen will capture the rook, the knight is pinned. And if he goes, black goes king h8 or king g8, then white can simply capture the knight with the idea to play queen h7 checkmate, attacking the rook as well. And white is probably winning. So after e5, black played the move f5 to block the line of the bishop. White took the pawn, again sacrificing the knight. Bishop captures knight and bishop captures pawn. In this position, white is a full rook down, but still black's king is the main problem over here. Both the bishops as well as the queen and the pawns in the center provide full compensation, as one day the pawn is also going to start moving and it is going to cause a lot of problem to the black pieces. Black played rook g8, bishop d2, because queen was capturing the bishop, so saving the bishop. Bishop g4, and here comes a very beautiful tactics. Try to find what white played. Queen e7 check. The knight cannot capture because of this pin. Rook g7, and again winning by pinning queen g5. Pinning the bishop. The bishop cannot move because you lose the queen. So black is forced to give up a bishop. Bishop captures g4, knight e7. And white saw here that he's having three extra pawns, and so he decided to exchange queens. Queen captures h5, bishop captures h5. In this position, the pawns will just roll out someday and white will eventually win. Rook g2 attacking the bishop. Bishop b4 attacking the knight. Knight d5. And again, white played here a very beautiful tactic. Bishop f3. Rook f2. Bishop captures knight, pawn captures knight, pawn captures bishop, bishop c5. Okay, now why this is a technically winning position. Three extra pawns, a6, b4, trying to create one more passed pawn over here. King g6, a4, king f5, b5, pawn captures pawn, pawn captures pawn, king e6, b6. Now white has two passed pawns. And okay, first bringing the king. King c6, e4, pawn captures king c4. White is threatening to give a check, So black pins the pawn, rook f4. But now this pawn starts running. E6, rook e4, e7, king d7, and b7. This is king c7. And again, here comes a very beautiful tactic. Pause the video and try to find a forced win. White gave a check. If the king captures, then the pawn will queen. And if king captures the pawn, white would just play bishop e5, blocking the line of the rook. And in the next move, white will queen. And due to this, Peter Lekko resigned. A beautiful game by Ivanchuk. If you like the video, please help the contribution by liking, sharing, and subscribing. Thanks for watching. Waiting for you in the next video. Thank you.